today, Sunday. It's the 5th of May 2024, and we're at the April Fair in Sinew. Yes, it's called the April Fair. It started in April, but it's continuing now. And behind us, we've got some horse displays, but there's going to be lots of things going on at this April Fair, so let's have a look around. It is an agricultural fair, so lots of things are based on sort of agricultural type things, and the first thing we've come across is horses, and there's a whole lot of people here enjoying watching the horse display across the road. It's busy, there's lots of people here, there's lots of roads that are closed, and well, we've managed to find a parking space, but we've had to walk quite a way just to get here. So this is just the first thing we've come across. Yes, Anita says watch where I'm walking because the horses have been here before. That's the main town of Sinew. There's the church, and they do have a fantastic market here on a Wednesday. And you can get here from Palmer by train. You can get the train from the intermodal station, and it will take you to Sinew if you go there on a Wednesday. It's about an hour's trip on the train, but it's quite scenic. You can see all the mountains. It passes through Inca, and you can see a bit of the island as you go. And it's not too expensive either. So we're going to leave the horses a bit behind and carry on up towards the village, town. So it's called the April Fair because it started a few weeks ago, and there's been events going on, and today is one of the big days, even though it's in May. And it doesn't finish here. There's at least another week of activities going on, so lots happening here in Sinew. You see how busy it is. I guess that's where we need to go, and we're going to go up a side street, so there shouldn't be any traffic around. The whole centre of the town has been pretty much sealed off, and the roads all in one direction now, so you have to circumnavigate the town. But it's obviously very well organised, and they've set up fields which have got suitable car parking, so loads of space for car parking, which was a bit of an issue. I'm quite often a bit dubious about parking in some of these car parks which are set up in fields, and there's a man standing there usually with his hand out. This one, no, it was all officially organised. The police were at the gate, and there were some high-vis people there just telling people where to go to park, but it all worked well. Oh, an air plant. Anita says they were happy when they're flowering, and that one's beautifully flowering. Well, today is Sunday, so it's not the usual market day. This is a special day. The usual market day is in the middle of the week. It's on a Wednesday, and well, it's still very good. And the temperature, it's warm. And Sinita says it's hot. Certainly, Sinita is not a typical holiday destination, but it's a hotel. It's called the Hotel Can Juan Capo, 4-star hotel, and it's adults only. Just getting close now to the middle of the village, and the density of the of people is increasing as we go up the road. Apologies for some problems I did have with the sound for a couple of the videos. It was all because I changed one of the camera settings and it actually changed the microphone setting. So it was using the front microphone instead of the rear microphone. Well, that's how it goes sometimes. And this is the main, one of the main squares. Now you get a feel as to how busy it is, people sitting at the bars. And we've got all of the different sorts of stalls here, which are normal market stalls, as well as some that you wouldn't normally expect as a market. And in that direction, that's where the railway station is, so just down that road. And it's quite easy to find. And the market on a normal day is in this area, and then it goes up to the church, which is up there. I did say that this is an agricultural fair, so it means we've got agricultural type things here. So we've got some gardening, farming type equipment from the smaller to the larger. I do find these things quite interesting to see. Is it boys and tractors? I don't know. We've got some of the charities working here as well. It's nice to see. This one is Contra Cancer. We have some animals on display. A bit of shade for them here. And of course, you get all of the smells that are associated with the farms and the countryside. Very long hair there. Highland cows, my goodness. I thought they were very comfortable in this climate. Waka Dexter. Goats. Dogs on the other side. The big blue tractors. Thank you.
do.
So on normal market day, there are not the animals here like there are today. This is especially for display purposes. Here are the black pigs doing what pigs do, basically lying around. Totally oblivious to the dog's barking. This is actually a Mallorquin cow. This one is Menorcan cow. Another Mallorcan cow. We do have sheep, these are Mallorcan sheep. Say hello. Lots more sheep in the pens down here. So they'll have a competition and prizes will be awarded. Just on this side, we've got quite a big pen that's been set up for the goats here, and some bales for them to climb up. The goats here do like to climb. We've got some mules. I'm not an expert on this sort of thing, I'm just reading the signs. It says mule. So it must be. Great variety of things. And nicely spread out so that you can actually get around not too bad. Considering the number of people that are here. Some swans. Bit of a garden here in the middle of the square. What about those? Quite colourful. Got a lot of pheasants here. And it is a fair, and a fair wouldn't be anything without a ride or two and something to keep the children occupied. There you go. Not for me, I'm afraid. Here we have a display of birds of prey, so we've got eagles and owls and that sort of a bird here. And while it's an agricultural fair, so we've got all things sort of agricultural here, we've also got a display of some cars, not many, but just a few to people's interested. This one, the Mini Moke, famous by The Prisoner. This is a Seat, like the Fiat 600. And of course, a Mini. Many people's first carring, including ours, of course. So another Seat 600. One's a Ford. That's old Land Rover. And then of all the classic cars, the Citroën de Chevaux. Another Fiat 600, so not a lot of cars in the distance. I can see some diggers, and I don't know whether that's a display or whether they're actually working diggers. We'll get down to there later on. It's just around the corner. I noticed some motorbikes, so have a quick look at the motorbikes. Just in this street here, we're managing to get a little bit of shade, and that's nice. We get out of the sun. Very much a parasol. Okay. So there you have the motorcycle section, starting off with the scooters, the Lambrettas and the like. So very nice condition Lambretta there. All in different states. Derby used to be extremely popular when we first came here. As a Honda. Something for your garden. And if you've got a very big garden, you might need something like this. How about a new Ferrari? Ferraris here come in different sizes. Even on a normal market day, they do have animals here, and you can actually buy and sell animals here. Maybe something like that's more your size. Some of these tractors are absolutely huge. It's like a Jeremy Clarkson tractor. It's in New Holland. The tire at the back, the wheel at the back's taller than me. Just go and stand by it a second, darling, so we've got to get a picture of how big it is. We've got a whole road of tractors down here. We've come back up to the square now, which is more tractors here. That's where the dogs are down there. We're just now on a slightly higher road. And just behind, this is where they normally sell the animals here. So it's just like a farmer's area for selling from birds through to sheep, goats. I've never seen anything as big as a cow on sale here, but I don't know, they may do that. And this is one of the areas where they sell the birds. And this is all part of the fair, so it's now all display, so you've got all the different birds that are bred on the island. Noisy in there. Here we've got some of the other birds on display on the outside. All given a nice shady area. Pigeons. There's some historical agricultural machinery. Now we've got some more traditional sorts of stalls, so chilies there, fruits and vegetables. Sobrasada over there. Cheese is on sale.
Hermanita, 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 chati.
Hermanita.
Carry on up that way. When we were both teaching at BIS, the Baleares International School, we used to bring groups of children to this market on a Wednesday when it was just the normal market, not this particular fair, which is on a Sunday. But the Wednesday market, they do have a few animals, and occasionally, I can remember one particular occasion when a child decided to buy some chicks, and they were in the coach on the way home. So I've come up another level. There's a street of over there of stalls, and we're going to go through this towards the church, which on a normal market day, again, there's stalls going up here. Shoes. Very crowded up here. Carry on going this way, we'll go towards the church. Hats, might need a hat.
Yeah, super low.
And here now we've got the more regular sort of stalls. Oh, Anita was looking for cowbells. How are your cowbells, dear? There's a stall over there doing cocktails. We've just made our way now. This is the church, and I will be going up the steps in a moment when Anita catches up with us. I've just got the steps now, and it's a narrow passageway, but if we go through this corner here, it will take us to the front of the church, and that's where there is another plaza in the square, where on a normal day it's full of fruit and vegetables. So we'll find out in a moment what's here on a fair day. A nice cool breeze blowing through here. It's the Sobrasada store, another one. And this is the entrance to the church. It's a Sunday, so there could well be a service on. This is a nice church. When we first started coming here, it was under renovation. That's all been completed now. And just in front of the church, we've got this little plaza, which today is mostly looks like flowers. Anita's going away, leaving me in charge of the garden. Oh, I don't know if I can take that responsibility. It's very busy around here. Demons. Every town has its demon. Have a demon shirt. Thank you. Crochet cactus. The table's outside. I'm guessing this might be a restaurant, and they're going to be opening up later on.
Yeah.
Yo sé de dónde.
Lots of the shops are open here as well, so they brought their goods out onto the street. You look a bit warm for Mallorca in May. Oh, this looks like much more fun. Catapults and crossbows and swords. Spoon tops. Books. Some of those are actually in English as well. Oh, again, out of the crowd and into a breeze. There's a bit of shade there. Sella San Torreo. Just going to come out near to the top of the main square.
Hola.
Just looking to see if there's anywhere for a drink. This is the main square and it's clearly very, very busy. And a lot of the places, people are now setting tables for lunch. Anyway, continue to have a little look around. I'm walking towards the railway station now. It's in this direction. I just pretty much went in a straight line. We'd bump into it. I did look at coming by train today, but from our house it would take about 2 hours to get to here, and it's only about 35 minutes in the car, so we chose the car. Look at all that lovely sobrasada. That would be something that is typical of breakfast.
Milo mi do
something that's also quite popular on these fairs are the stalls that make fresh crisps. Buy yourself a big bag of potato crisps, and of course all the sweets and nuts and all of these sorts of things. Another square here full of things. This is a very extensive sweet things. Pony rides. Another attractions for the young ones. One of the problems I always find with these things is knowing exactly when they're on. People here will all know it's April Fair time. unless you're looking for it, it's easy to miss. And I only caught this just looking through the newspaper on the What's On.
Yo la tengo.
Kojak popper just saw there. Remember Kojak? He'd always got one of those lollipops stuck in his mouth. And you see there's a level crossing in front of us, that's indicating that we're very close to the railway. And the station's just down there. And there's more fairground attractions across the road. Well, it's quite a fair here in Sinew, and we've more or less done a complete circle. I'm not sure we've seen everything, there's I think still a lot more to see, but we need a drink and there's nowhere that we could find that we could have a drink. It was just way too busy, way too full. So we're off somewhere else. We'll see if we can find somewhere for a little refreshment. So bye for now.
Bye.
Bye.